Listen, I would say you can't do anything at that moment, but before that you have to develop your personality. I would give you some tips what you can do to develop your personality. You need to take 5 days off. 1 day you need to spend in a mental hospital. Just talk to people and see, or just assume you are a doctor in a mental hospital. Would the doctor mind whatever the patient says? If he minds, he loses the qualification of being a doctor. Got it? You must simply realize there are many patients who are not in the hospital but around you. Second tip would be, 1 day you need to spend in a school, maybe challenge children's school. You teach them something, they don't learn it so easily. As a primary teacher, do you know how much patience a primary teacher need to have? 2 plus 2 is 4. They'll say, 2 plus 2, 5. Say, no, 4. 4, 4, 4. And then, 2 plus 2, how much? 5, madam. Have you seen children saying that? You need some patience to teach kids. And especially if they've learned it wrong, to correct them is a challenge. And challenge children, even more patience you need. So 1 day if you spend in school, let me say, one is being a farmer. Get to plant trees, spend a whole day watering the trees, then you will value food, you won't waste it. 3 is over, and then the 4th is getting into a prison. Spend 1 day with the criminals there, you know. You will have a completely different perspective about their life and how they got in there and what is their life. Compassion will come to you. You know, commitment for the planet will come to you when you be a farmer for a day. 1 day in prison will bring you compassion, which you will never forget in your life. And the last one I still will reserve for you another time.
So why we know that when we have detected the earliest signs of coronary artery disease, so we can do many things, and these are all things that you must have been sick of hearing, but they are very effective. There's no question, there are many, many studies that have been done around the world which shows full principle, what you like the most, that is fried stuff and sweet stuff, you eat the least. Meats and dairy products, second least. Vegetables and fruits, the most. And carbohydrates also, but carbohydrates, not the regular carbohydrates, but complex carbohydrates. So potatoes, white bread, all that stuff is not so good. Refined sugar is not good. But if you go for mixed grain bread, or mixed grain rotis and all that, that's much better, much healthier. So steer yourself away from white maida and stuff like that. So like, you know, burgers and stuff which are made from white bread. So just a little visual of what's good or bad. You've heard this many times and you must be sick of it. Smoking or tobacco in any form is extremely harmful. Don't have to say that again. Alcohol. Anybody wants to know about alcohol? 2 small drinks 4 times a week. If you skip 1 day, you don't double the next day. So, because of the fact, you know, binging is at your age is a favorite. So, I mean, we have all done it, and I'm sure you're not stopping by my saying so. But the basic thing is that if the alcohol level in your blood goes up, it starts irritating the intimal lining, the endothelium of the arteries. So, over a period of time, it will hurt you. So, do process it the way you want to. So, just as a reminder, these are the few things that you can do for yourself. So, the basic thing is that if you look at the body, not with just disease. So some people come to us and say, I've got a backache, or I've got abdominal ache, or I've got heart problem. That if you start looking at just that and treating just that, then you have missed the full forest. So you know, you need to now reorient yourself and say, why did this happen? What are the footprints that led to this problem? So if you look at it that way, then the chances of actually treating the whole human being becomes extremely more successful and leads you from not just taking out your gallbladder, but or not doing just this, but to saying what led to this and what will happen in the future. So I think that's the basic change in our thinking, and that's what I wanted to share with you today. Thank you so much.